Last session, we were discussed about the logistic regression. How do we build the logistic regression? Before we are building the model, what we have done, we come up with the linear regression. What is the drawback of linear regression? Maybe it is a simple linear regression or multiple linear regression. Linear regression, simple or multiple, will work when it is dependent variable as well as independent variables should be in the form of continuous in nature. Whereas if it is in the form of binary, it doesn't work. In that place, what we are using? We are using the logistic regression. The formula for the logistic regression is P of y by x is equal to exponential of beta naught plus beta 1x divided by 1 plus exponential of beta naught plus beta 1 x. P of y by x is equal to exponential of beta naught plus beta 1 x divided by 1 plus exponential of beta naught plus beta 1 x. Here we would like to predict the probability of y. Y means dependent variable based on the independent variables. Here in this case, we would like to predict the probabilities of y. Y means dependent variable. By using the independent variable here. So when you build the linear regression, we got the value, right? We got the predicting as a we predicted as the value. But whereas in the logistic regression, when we are using the logistic regression, we are going to get the probability values. First of all, try to understand what we are trying to predict. Here in this case, we have a two variables. If we are going with an example, here in the product sales, we have the two variables, age and bought. By using the age, we would like to predict whether customer will buy the product or not. Let me repeat. We would like to predict by using the age, we would like to predict whether customer will buy the product or not. So here 1 means buying the product, 0 means not buying the product. Here in this case, we are going to use the, let's say, first table of, I just want to say how many zeros are there, how many ones are there in the bot option, bot variable. Count the frequency of one and zeros in bot variable. For that, how do you find the frequency? Table function of product sales dollar bot. Product sale dot bot. Here in this case, 0 and 1. 0 means 260 out of 467 customers. 0 means 262 customers are not buying the product. Only 205 customers are buying the product. That is the meaning of the bot variable. Here, we would like to build the logistic regression model in this variable. How do we build the logic? First of all, let me check what are the variable names. Names of product sales. Automatically it will give. We have the two variables, age and bought. Now we would like to build the logistic regression model. So in this case, model 1 is equal to, model 1 is equal to GLM of H, sorry, first we need to write dependent variable, right? What is the dependent variable? Tilde H comma family is equal to binomial, family is equal to binomial comma data is equal to products. Here, why we are mentioning the family? Back end, it follows the binomial distribution. If in case we did not mention the family is equal to binomial, it doesn't build the model for the zero, or it is giving the whatever the probability value. Based on that value, it building the model. But ideally, do we need to build the model for zero, or do we need to build the model for one? We have to always make sure whatever you are trying to predict, you are trying to predict in our case, buy or not buy. Are you going to build the model for buying customers, or are you going to build the model for non-buying customer? Definitely, we are going to build the model for buying customer. For non-buying customer, not buying customer, it doesn't make sense to build the model for them. So we are always going to build the model for buying customers only. So if I run this statement, summary of this model, here, as we discussed in the Friday started also, here the first one is the call GLM formula is equal to bot tilde H, family is equal to binomial, data is equal to deviation residuals is nothing but the minimum value in the error, deviation residuals is nothing but error, basically minimum error, first quarter, maximum error, median value, all these things. Coefficients is nothing but beta naught, all these things. Now here we would like to check what is the formula for this. So here the intercepts with coefficients, right? Y is equal to beta naught plus beta 1 x. What is the formula beta naught? Beta naught is nothing but intercept value is the beta naught, that is minus 6.90975. Y is equal to minus 6.90975 plus 0.21 into age, right? So is it a linear equation or logistic regression? This equation is a linear equation, the linear regression or linear. But what is our equation is? Our equation we are using exponential equation, right? P of y by x, that is the exponential of beta naught plus beta 1 x divided by 1 plus exponential of beta naught plus beta 1 x. Am I right? Here in this case, what happened? If I mention the y is equal to, means p of y by x is equal to, so this is the beta naught, this is the beta 1 x. So instead of this one, can I mention the y value? So p of y by x is equal to exponential of y divided by 1 plus exponential of y. The reason P of y by x is equal to exponential of y divided by 1 plus exponential of y. Why we got this one? The reason P of y by x is equal to exponential of y by 1 plus exponential of y. The reason it is a linear logistic. The first one equation we got as a linear regression. Let me, how do I predict the probability values for the same? Is everyone is clear about this logic? How we got it? The equation? Now, how do I write this one? Here, this is the standard error, all these things which we got. Now, dispersion parameter for binomial family taken to be 1. So that means we are building the model for all the, you know, buying customers. Null deviance means error of the independent variable. Null deviance is nothing but error of independent variable. The formula is n minus 1. N minus 1. Because if you want to consider the null deviance, all the independent variables, the formula is n minus 1. N is nothing but number of observation. 1 is the one dependent variable. So total variable is the total observations are 467. It is considered the 466. Residual deviation is nothing but error of the standard error. The formula is n minus k minus 1. N is 467, k is one independent variable and one dependent variable. So we got 465. Fisher is the scientist who found this algorithm. Now, in everyone's mind, we got the two questions, I think. One, how do I measure the accuracy of this model? How do I measure the accuracy of the model? How do I predict in the probability value? Now, what happens? Let me go with one simple example. Let's say new data is equal to just validating our model is correct or not. Validating the model with new data. So new underscore data is equal to data dot frame age is equal to 4. Age is equal to 4. So are we got the age is a 4? Now what happened? Age is equal to 4. Now we would like to predict the value. What is the function? Predict of model 1 comma new underscore data. What if I now we as we discussed in logistic regression, we are getting the predicting probability value is ranging from 0 to 1. Am I right? 0 to the ideal, the probability value is ranging from 0 to 1. But here, when we are considering new data, age is equal to 4, what is the probability whether customer will buy the product or not? Now, let's run this. -6.03. What is the wrong with it? Now let me go back with the same scenario as our whatever we have discussed. This is the equation. Y is equal to -6.9071 plus 0.21783 into age is equal to 4. Am I right? So y is equal to -6.90 plus 0.8. That is nothing but -6.02. Am I right? What is the answer we got? Around the same. -6.03. Here what we got the value? -6.03. Exactly the same only. But what is this equation? Does the selected equation, the rounded equation, is a linear equation or a logistic regression equation? This is a linear equation. But what we need to do? We need to convert that equation into logistic regression. What is the formula for the logistic regression? Exponential of beta naught plus beta 1x divided by 1 plus exponential of beta naught plus beta 1x. So that means exponential of -6.02 divided by 1 plus exponential of -6.02. Now how do I write this thing? How do I do this thing here? Here predict after predict, if we did not mention anything, it will consider linear regression only. Predict of model 1 comma new underscore data comma type is equal to response. Type is equal to response. If you mention the type is equal to response, means if you mention the, if we mention the type is equal to response, it will consider linear equation into logistic equation. If you did not mention the type is equal to response, what it will do? It will consider as the linear equation. If you mention the type is equal to response, you will get into the logistic. Even if you have a doubt, can we check with the Excel also? So, right, the formula for the Excel is exponential of minus 6.03 right is equal to this divided by 1 plus what is the value of that? 0.00237 is nothing but rounded value is the 234. Is it that equation? Does it make? First, what we are doing? This is the exponential of minus 6.02. What is the formula below 1? 1 plus exponential of minus 6.02. So simply, if you want to write here, forget about these two. How do we write? Exponential is equal to exponential of minus 6.02. This is the value of the 1. Next is the 1 plus the formula, right? Exponential of beta naught plus beta 1x divided by 1 plus exponential. So exponential of minus 6.02. So exponential of this divided by this value 0.224, which is the exactly the same value, which is the exactly 0.234 is nothing but this is the same equation we got, right? So that is the meaning. If I mention the type is equal to response, it will convert the linear regression equation into logistic equation. Even if I have a doubt, can we check with the when age is equal to when age is equal to 70, then what is the probability? Then what is the probability customer will buy the product? When age is equal to 40, what is the probability customer will buy the product? Here in this case, what we are going to do, new underscore data, data dot frame, age is equal to 70. Now predict function, syntax is predict model 1. Model 1 is the whatever we have assigned the model equation. New underscore data comma type is equal to response. If we mention the type is equal to, that is the 0.9976. This is the meaning of the probability value. Is everyone is clear? How do we get the predicting probability value? Now you may get, for the given data product sales 467 observation, how do I get the probability values? Simple, the same way predicting the probability values. predicting the values for product sale data. So what I am doing, product sale comma dollar pred. Pred is the predicting probability value. Okay, now here we need to just predict of then we need to store the model one comma type is equal to when we got the this is the value. These are the all the predicting value for the 467 records. This is the, all the 467 records. Any questions about how do we predict the probability values, all these things? Any questions, guys? Is it clear or not clear?
It's clear, Koti.
Yeah, clear. Yeah, okay. Now everyone, next topic. Now in linear regression, simple linear regression or multiple linear regression, we measure the accuracy, right, by using the r square means multiple r square or adjusted r square. But in the logistic regression is also called as a classification. Just we are classifying buying customer versus not buying customer. To measure the accuracy of the model, we are going to use the classification table. To measure the accuracy of the model, in logistic regression to measure the accuracy of the model in logistic regression we are going to use the classification table, classification matrix, or the classification matrix also called as a confusion matrix. Matrix is nothing but classification table, classification matrix or bracket table or confusion matrix. How do we draw the confusion matrix in that data? To draw the confusion matrix, we require two variables. We require two variables. Those are actual dependent variables. In our case, what is the actual dependent variable? Bot is the actual dependent variable. In the bot, we have the two levels, 0 and 1. And other one is the predicted variable. Predicted variable means we got the predicting probability value variable. That is the mean. And here in this case, how do we draw the confusion matrix? Here, this is the 0, 1. This is the actual table. This is the 0, 1. This is the predicted. 0, 0 is called as a true positive. I will explain about that. 0, 1 is called as a false negative. 1, 0 is called false positive. This is the true negative. Assume that 0 is the positive. 1 is the negative. Here also 0 is positive. 1 is negative. Here. In the in actual dependent variable, assume that in our predicted product sales, we have the two variables, age and but. But if you are building the logistic regression model, to measure the accuracy of the model, we need to draw the confusion matrix or classification table. To measure that or to draw the confusion matrix or a classification table, we require the two variables. Those are, one is actual dependent variable, other one is your predicted variable. Always the left side, this portion, the left side, this portion is, the left side, this portion is actual variable. The this portion will be, this is the actual variable, always in the real time also. This is the predicted variable. Now you may get the doubt. Here in the predicting probabilities, the probability values is ranging from 0 to 1. But you have mentioned the 0 and 1. What about the remaining values? We need to convert the entire probability values 0 and 1. How do we convert the 0 and 1? By default, threshold value is 0.5. Why we consider threshold value 0.5? I will explain in the next session. The reason is that why we got this one. And here in this case, if it is less than 0.5, we consider as 0. If it is greater than 0.5, we can consider as 1. The predicting probability is less than 0.5. We can consider as 0. Predicting probability is greater than 0.5. We can consider as 1. That is the default value. The reason why we consider 0.5, when we, what is the backend distribution we are using? Backend distribution for the logistic regression, we are using as binomial distribution. If we toss, how many possible outcomes we have? Two possible outcome, right? If I toss a coin, if we assume that we have toss a coin, what are the possible outcomes we are going to, get? Either head or tail. Am I right? What is the probability to get the head? 50% chances. What is the probability to get the tail? 50% chances. So that means equal proportion to get the positives or negative. In our case, buying or not buying is the 50%, right? Generally, if you look into the binomial distribution, equal proportion to get the buying or not buying is 0.5. In all the cases, we have the only two possible outcomes, dependent variable. If the binary variable is a dependent variable, only two possible outcomes, either success or failure. Always 0 or 1. Product response, non-response. Buying, not buying. Win or lose. In all the cases, the probability getting equal, win is the chances, equal chances is the 50, lose also equal chances is the 50. So that is the reason default threshold value we are considering as 0.5. If it is less than 0.5, we are considering as not buying. Greater than 0.5, we are considering buy. You may get the doubt. Why you are considering greater than 0.5 as a buy, less than 0.5 as a not buy? Can't we do a flip it, reverse of it? The reason why we consider as 1, because we are building a model for buying customer rather than not buying customer. Always we are building, that means the probability values will be high. So that is the reason we are considering them as a greater than 0.5 as 1, else 0. That is how we converted the 0 and 1. Clear? Let me repeat again if you want, everyone. In binomial distribution, getting equal portion of the portion of success or failure is 0.5. So equal proportion, right? Success are 50%, failure also 50%. Ideal cases I'm talking about. But in the logistic regression, back end we are using the binomial distribution. In ideal cases, threshold value means default probability value is 0.5. In ideal cases, default probability value is 0.5. If it is less than 0.5 and greater than 0.5, less than or equal to 0.5. Less than 0.5 is nothing but not by, less than or equal to greater than 0.5, greater than by customer. That is how we convert this one into, in binomial distribution, getting equal proportion of success or failure is 0.5. In logistic regression, back end we are using the binomial. In ideal cases, getting the probability values, ideal probability is 0.5. So that is the reason we are considering as the default threshold value is 0.5. In going forward, we have a next session, model selection. We have one topic is the model selection. There we will get to know how do we choose the optimal threshold value. There we will discuss in detail about the optimal threshold value. By now, let's remember the optimal threshold value as the 0.5. That is the default. Why we consider the default? Because equal proportion getting the possible outcomes. So that is the reason we are getting the 0.5. Guys, is it clear? One of the important points here, this is. Anyone having a doubt about this?
Koti?
Yeah.
Koti, I got disconnected. I lost your explanation. Now, can you give me once again?
Here in the binomial distribution, we are trying to measure the accuracy in logistic regression. We are going to use the classification table or confusion matrix. To measure that, we need to require the two variables. If you would like to construct the or drawing the confusion matrix or classification table, we require the two variables. One is actual dependent variable and other variable is predicted values. The ideal range of predicted values is from 0 to 1. But here we are converting into 0 and 1. How do we convert them 0 into 1? The probability value less than 0.5 we are considering as 0. The probability value is greater than or equal to 0.5 we are considering as 1. You may get that doubt why we need to consider 0.5 as a threshold point. The reason is that in binomial backend algorithm of logistic regression, we are using the binomial distribution. In binomial distribution, we have the two possible outcomes, success or failure, yes or no, 1 or 0, win or lose, response, not response, churn, not churn, buy, not buy. In all the cases, equal proportion, when I toss a coin, equal proportion is getting a head is the 50% chances, getting a tail is also 50%. 50% means 0.5 is the probability value. So that is the reason we are considering the 0.5 as the threshold value. Now here, how do we convert them? Positive to negative, true positive, false negative and true negative. Let me do this with an examples. 0, 1. 0, 1. 0 means I said the positive, negative, here also positive, here also negative. This is the true positive. True positive means your actual data is positive. Your actual data is positive. Our model also predicting them as a positive only. Here positive, here also positive. Our model is also predicting them as positive. This is called as true positive. this is the 0, 1. This is the false negative. False negative is nothing but.
Got you one doubt here.
Yeah.
Actual data is from tables. Table. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
From where we got this predicted positive and predicted negative?
We build the model, right? When we build the model for each and every record, we got the predicting probabilities. From the predicted probabilities, default values 0.5 we are considering, greater than 0.5 we are considering as a 1, less than 0.5 we are considering as a 0. So we get the predicting values 0 and 1. So by using these two variables, we are getting the 0 and 1. Clear? I will show you in that data. Give me two.
Yeah, clear now.
I will show you all. Just I am giving the theoretical example. I will show you in the practical also. Give me some time. False negative means your actual data is positive. Our model predicting them as a negative. So we are considering as a false negative because wrongly classified. Positive has been classified as a negative. That is not the make sense. Those are the false negative. Here 1, 0, that is a false positive. That means your actual data is negative. Actual data is negative, but our model predicting them as the positive. That is the meaning of false positive. False positive. False negative means your actual data is positive. Actual data is positive, but our model predicting them as the negative. That is the false negative. False positive means your actual data is negative. The left side, this is the actual data. This is the predicted data. This is the actual. This is the predicted. The above one is the predicted. The left side is the your actual data is negative and our model predicting them as a positive. That is the false positive. True negative means your actual data is negative. Our model also predicting them as the negative. To measure the accuracy is equal to true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus false negative plus false positive plus true negative. Accuracy is equal to true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus false negative plus false positive and then false true negative. That is the meaning of the accuracy. Let's do this in the lab. Automatically you will get the one clarity. Here we have the, if you go here, we have the predicted value. What is the minimum predicted value? Min means minimum value it will give. Min of product sale, dollar, predicted value, 0.0012. Max means the maximum of product sale, dollar, rate, 0.995. Now you need to convert less than 0.5. We are considering as the 1. And now how do we convert? Let's keep as a threshold is equal to threshold 0.5. Reason, in binomial distribution, getting equal portion of probability values equal portion of probability equal portion of probability value is 0.5. So equal, let's say getting an equal opportunity for head, our tail is the 0.5. Now we need to build the PRED class. And just we are keeping product sales dot PRED class. PRED class is equal to, you can write anything, ABC, or you can write anything. If else, why are writing if else? Product sales dollar spread greater than threshold value greater than or equal to threshold value. Threshold value means 0.5, else 1, otherwise 0. Here what we are doing, we need to convert the predicting probability value into 0 and 1. How do we convert threshold value? What is the threshold value? 0. If it is greater than or equal to 0.5, we can consider as 1. Else 0. The syntax, how do we convert? By using the if else condition, we are creating a new variable. Product sale dollar pred class is equal to if else product sale dollar pred greater than or equal to threshold value. Threshold value means 0.5. It will get the 1. Otherwise, we will get the 0. Let's run this one. Now, can we check? We are able to create the value 0 and 1. Now, let's cross verify in the predicted class how many zeros are there, how many 1s are there. Counting the 1s and zeros in predicted class. Table of product sales dollar pred class, the one we have created, zeros are the 260, ones are the 207. Now we would like to constructing the classification table. Constructing the classification table. How do we construct the classification table? Here table of, I mean you can write conf matrix or you can write your own also conf matrix. Table of, first what we need to write? First actual depend variable. Product sales dollar bought comma product sale dollar pred class. Am I right? To draw the confusion matrix or classification table, we required the two variables. What are the two variables? Actual depend variable, predicted class variable. So conf matrix, this is how we got it. 205 257 53 202. Let me explain you about this. Zero, one, zero, one. What is the meaning? 257 257 53 202. Right? Here zero means not buying customers. Here one means buying customer. Buy. Here one zero means not buying. Here one means buying customer. Right? Let me draw this. Or else you can write, let me write down in the very clear format. 0, 1, 0, 1, 2, 5, 7, 5, 3, 2, 0, 2. Here 0 means not buying. N means not buying. 1 means buy. right? This is also n by, not by, this is the by, this is the table. Now let's understand how many are the total non-buying. This is equal to 257 plus 5 is equal to total actual buying. This is the actual data, this is the predicted, right? Here how many are the not buying? Total 262, 257 plus 5 is the 262. In actual data, how many are ones are there? 205, 202 plus 203. If you have a doubt about this, let me get the table of product sale dollar bought. See, zeros are the 262, ones are the how many? 205. Here the same thing in actual data. Here also this is the 262 zeros, ones are the 205. Here true positive, this is the true positive, this is the false negative, this is the false positive plus true negative. Here actual customer, total 262 customers are not buying customer. Out of that, 257 customers has been classified or predicted as not buying customers, but five not buying customers has been classified as the buying customers. Here total customers are 262 customers. Out of that 262 customers, 257 customers has been classified as or has been predicted as not buying customers, but five customers, actual those are the not buying customer, but our model predicting them as the buying customer. In total there are 205 buying customers. Out of that, three customers has been classified as the not buying customers and remaining 202 customers has been classified as the buying customer. Here how do we measure the accuracy? Accuracy is equal to true positive, that is 250, the formula is 257 plus 202 divided by total is 257 plus 202 plus 5 plus 3. That simple formula is true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus false negative plus false positive plus true negative. So simply accuracy is 257, that is 457 divided by 467. That is the total number of records. Sorry, 459 divided by, simply we can write the accuracy is equal to 1, 1. 1, 1 is the first row, right? That is the first row, means this is the first row. See, if you are looking about the confusion matrix, here confusion matrix of 1, 1, that means 257 conf matrix of second row, second column we require, right? 2, 2, 202, sum of conf matrix 467 total, the same way, plus conf matrix of 2, 2 divided by sum of conf matrix. Sorry. Oh. See, now the accuracy means 98% of the time. The accuracy means 98% of the time we are able to classify the positives as positives and negatives as negative. The remaining 1% of the time we are not able to classify them as properly. That is the meaning of logistic, simple logistic regression. Any questions about this one? Is it clear, guys? What we have discussed here, first, if you want to build the logistic regression, make sure or ensure that always your dependent variable is a binary variable, 0 or 1. And the formula is, the backend of logistic regression works as the binomial distribution. The assumptions or properties of the binomial distribution, which are number of trials, are fixed. That means in our case, number of observations or records are they fixed. There are the two possible outcomes in the logistic regression dependent variables. The two possible, 0 and 1. Whatever we are trying to predict, that is the success you are trying to predict. Whatever you are not trying to predict, that is the zeros. So always in the logistic regression in industry also, make sure that whatever you are trying to predict, that is always 1. Not trying to predict, that is always 0. Next, third point. The probability of success is given to the p-value. Probability of failure is given to the q-value. One trial is independent with the other trial. That meaning is, the first record should not influence the second record, or second record should not influence the third record. The same way going forward. The same way like as other. The next, this is the form. The syntax for the logistic regression is GLM. GLM means generalized linear model of dependent variable tilde independent variable comma family is equal to binomial. If you mention the mention family is equal to binomial, it ensures that it building a model for the probability of success. If not, it will build the model for on top of the probability value. That is result correct. Comma data is equal to whatever a data set name, and then we will get the output. But by using the output, we will check the coefficients are significant or not significant. But to measure the accuracy, we are going to use the confusion matrix. To draw the confusion matrix, we are going to use the two variables. One is actual dependent variable, second one is predicted variable. Now in the predicted variable, we got the predicting probabilities, which is ranging from 0 to 1. But actual dependent variable 0 and 1. We need to convert them 0 and 1. For that purpose, we are using the threshold value as 0.5. You may get the doubt why we are using the threshold value as 0.5. When we consider the binomial distribution, the equal proportion to get the success or failure is 0.5. That is a 50%. So here also we are considering equal proportion to get the success or failure. We are considering the probability value as 0.5. Whatever you are trying to predict which is greater than 0.5 is 1 always, because we are always trying to build a model for 1. That is, greater than 0.5 is always 1, less than 0.5 is the 0. So that we will get the confusion. In the confusion matrix, we will get the 4 value. True positive, in actual data is a positive. If your model is also predicting as a positive, that is called as the true positive. False negative means your actual data is a positive, your model predicting them as a negative. That is called as the false negative. Your actual data is negative, but our model predicting them as a positive. That is called as the false positive. Your actual data is negative, our model predicting them as the negative. That we can call as the true negative. True negative. To measure the accuracy of the model is true positive plus true negative divided by true positive plus true negative plus false negative. That is nothing but your accuracy of the model. That is how we are building the model for simple logistic regression model. Tomorrow we will discuss about multiple logistic regression. That is all about today's session.